Hello everyone, welcome to yet another fantastic episode of Joel's Bible Days. Let's pray to the Lord our God real quick, and then we'll get started. Alright. Dear God, thank you for being the wonderful God that you are, the holy God that you are. Thank you for all you do for us. Thank you for dying on the cross for our sins so that we could live. Just thank you, Lord, for being the greatest God ever. I also pray that my brother Chase, that you'll help him to continue having no more seizures, along with his autism and other people like him. I also pray for people having COVID or in a bad time that they'll feel better soon. I pray that COVID-19 will go away soon, and that the better times are on the way, and that the rules will go back to normal. I just pray the best for everyone, and I pray for people that have struggles in their life, that, like Faith and Dan, that you'll help them, Lord. And I just pray the best for everyone. In Jesus' name, amen. So sorry if I stop a lot in this episode. I have something stuck in my throat. This is actually the second time I record this episode. I didn't like my recording last time, so, yeah. I'll do my best, though. So anyways, please jump into your Bible to Numbers chapter 32. If you do not have a Bible, then please turn on the captions if they are allowed. If they're not allowed, then please listen along carefully. But anyways, please pause this if you do have a Bible to Numbers chapter 30 to get to Numbers chapter 32. And you can get this, you can unpause this when you're ready. But anyways, here is Numbers chapter 32, the first 21 verses out of 42, which I'll read later. Alright, Numbers chapter 32. Reuben and Gad settle in Gilead. Now the people of Reuben and the people of Gad had a very great number of livestock. And they saw the land of Jazer and the land of Gilead, and behold, the place was a place of livestock. So the people of Gad and the people of Reuben came and said to Moses and to Eleazar the priest and to the chiefs of the congregation, Atarah, Dibon, Jazer, Nimrah, Heshbon, Elilah, Elealeh, Sibam, and Nebo, and beyond, the land that the Lord struck down before the congregation of Israel. It's a land of livestock, and your servants have livestock. Excuse me. And they said, if we found this favor in your sight, let this land be given to your servants for a possession. Do not take us across the Jordan. But Moses said to the people of Gad and the people of Reuben, shall your brothers go to the war while you sit here? Why will you discourage the heart of the people of Israel from going over into the land that the Lord has given them? Your fathers did this, when I sent from Kadesh Barnea to see the land, when they went up to the valley of Eshcol, and saw the land, they discouraged the heart of the people of Israel from going into the land that the Lord had given them. And the Lord's anger was kindled on that day, and he swore, saying, surely none of the men who came up out of Egypt from 20 years and upward shall see the land that I swore to give to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, because they have not wholly found me. None except Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, and Joshua, the son of Nun, for they have wholly followed the Lord, and the Lord's anger was kindled against Israel, and he made them wander in the wilderness for 40 years until all the congregation had done evil, and the sight of the Lord was gone. Excuse me. Anyways, verse 14, and behold, you have risen in your father's place a bread of sinful man to increase more the fierce anger of the Lord against Israel, for if you will turn away from following them, he will again abandon them in the wilderness, and you will destroy all this people. Then they came near to him and said, we will build sheepfolds here for our livestock and cities for our little ones. But we will take up arms, right, to go before the people of Israel until we have brought them to their place. and our little ones shall live in the fortified cities because of the inhabitants of the land. We will not return to our homes until each of the people of Israel has gained his inheritance, for we will not inherit with them on the other side of the Jordan and beyond, because our inheritance has come to us on this side of the Jordan to the east. So Moses said to them, if you will do this, if you will take up arms to go before the Lord for the war, and every armed man of you will pass over the Jordan before the Lord until he has driven out his enemies from before him. Yay, wasn't that a nice first half? Well, anyways, we're going to read the rest of that later, the last half of that later, so. Yeah, well, sorry, I forgot to say, that's the only chapter we're reading today, and this we're going to do one song now by Phil Wickham, and the other one is a new one by, U.S. Worship. I don't know how to pronounce that, but yeah. Anyways, please don't forget to sing along, and let's sing Where I'm Standing Now by Phil Wickham. You may know it, but anyways, please don't forget to sing along. Sing along. All right, let's do it. Hey, Google. Play Where I'm Standing Now by Phil Wickham.
Where I'm Standing Now by Phil Wickham. Sure. Playing on YouTube Music.
Out of the wilderness, into your deliverance, look where I'm standing. Hands that once were chained, now lifted high in praise. Look where I'm standing now. Look where I'm standing now. I stand on the chain breaking, miracle making, powerful name of Jesus. On the promised land, look where I'm standing now.
Yay, wasn't that a beautiful worship song? As I've said many, many times, Phil Wickham has a beautiful voice, a loving voice, a great singing voice. He loves God. Yeah, I just love him so much. So, yeah. Phil Wickham, if you're watching, I say hi. Well, anyways, please jump back into your Bibles to Numbers chapter 32. We're now going to read verses 22 to 42. If you do not have a Bible, then please comment in the captions if they are allowed in this video. If they're not, then please listen along. But anyways, if you're not turned on into Numbers chapter 32, again, then please pause this so you can get into this. But anyways, here is Numbers chapter 32, verses 22 to 42. And the land is subdued before the Lord. Then after that you shall return and be free of obligation to the Lord and to Israel. And this land shall be your possession before the Lord. But if you will not do so, behold, you have sinned against the Lord. Be sure your sin will find you out. Excuse me. Build cities for your little ones and folds for your sheep, and do what you have promised. And the people of Gad and the people of Reuben said to Moses, your servants will do as my Lord commands. Our little ones, our wives, our livestock, and all our cattle shall remain there in the cities of Gilead. But your servants will pass over, every man who is armed for war, before the Lord to battle, as my Lord orders. So Moses gave command concerning them to Eleazar the priest, and to Joshua the son of Nun, and to the heads of the fathers' houses of the tribes of the people of Israel. Excuse me. And Moses said to them, if the people of Gad and the people of Reuben, every man who is armed to battle the Lord, will pass with you over the Jordan, and the land shall be subdued before you, then you shall give them the land of Gilead for possession. However, if they will not pass over with you armed, they shall have possessions among you in the land of Canaan. And the people of Gad and the people of Reuben answered, what the Lord has said to your servants we will do. We will pass over armed before the Lord into the land of Canaan, and the possession of our inheritance shall remain with us beyond the Jordan. And Moses gave to them, to the people of Gad, and to the people of Reuben, and to the half-tribe of Manasseh, the son of Joseph, the kingdom of Sihon, king of the Amorites, and the kingdom of Og, king of Bashan, the land and its cities with their territories, the cities of the land, throughout the country. And the people of Gad built Dibon, Ataroth, sorry, this is a confusing word, so I don't know. Sorry about that if I'm saying it wrong. Ataroth, Shaphan, Jazer, Jugbaha, Beth Nimra, and Beth Haran, fortified cities, and folds for sheep. And the people of Reuben built Heshbon, Elilah, or something like that. Kiriathaim, Nebo, and Baal-meon, their names were changed, and Sibmah. And they gave other names to the cities that they built. Anyways, verse 39, and the sons of Machir, or Masur, the son of Manasseh, went to Gilead and captured it, and were dispossessed to the Amorite, and dispossessed the Amorites who were in it. And Moses gave Gilead to Machir, the son of Manasseh, and he settled in it. And Jair, the son of Manasseh, went and captured their villages, and called them Havoth Jair. Excuse me. The final verse. And Noba went and captured Kenneth and its villages, and called it Noba after his own name. Yay, wasn't that a nice chapter? I actually made it through the whole chapter this time. Last time I recorded this, I just couldn't. Well, anyways, let's jump into our next and new worship song. This is Our Story by V.O.U.S. Maybe Vows, I don't know, Vows Worship. So, you know, anyways, let's sing it. I'll try to give you the lyrics as much as I can. So, yeah. Hey, Google. Play This Is Our Story by V.O.U.S. Worship.
This is Our Story by VOU Worship. Sure. Playing on YouTube
Whatever
Music.
It's called.
Mm-hmm. flesh, traded heaven's glory, Messiah of the mess. He is hope and forgiveness, shepherd of the restless, heals the brokenness. I surrender all I am to you, guide forever I'm yours. The wonder of the cross holds the power of our peace. The Father's heart revealed on Calvary. Emmanuel, forever God with us. The world has never seen a greater to us. Grace that never ends, truth that never bends. He is light in the darkness. For the lonely and the lost, He will always be enough. For the lonely and the lost, He will always.
Yay, wasn't that a nice worship song? Oh, let me turn that off. Yay, wasn't that a nice worship song? I always love bringing new worship songs. Well, anyways, let's read a few verses from Psalms chapter 1 real quick, verses 1 to 3. You don't need your Bibles for this, but please listen along. Alright, here's Psalm chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. The way of the righteous and the wicked. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. Yay. Oh, wait. In all that he does, he prospers. Yay, wasn't that nice? Well, anyways, besides that, please, I'm sorry that if I got any of the words wrong, so, yeah. Because there's a lot of words that are hard, so, yeah. Well, anyways, let's praise the Lord our God real quick, and then I'll say goodbye. Dear God, thank you for being the holy God, the greatest God ever. Thank you for letting us live on earth. Thank you for being the best God you can ever be. And just thank you, Lord. I also pray that my brother Chase, and that you'll help him with his autism and his seizures, along with other kids like him. And also pray for people having COVID-19 or a bad time, that they'll feel better soon. Also pray for people, that COVID-19 will go away soon, and that the rules will go back to normal. And, yeah, I also pray for people in a bad time, that have struggles in their life, like Faith and Dan, that you'll help them, Lord. And I pray for people lost, that they'll find you, and people still loving you, that we will love you forever, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, anyways, please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Joel Hancock, below. Like if you liked this video, and, also, please don't forget to watch till the end of my video somehow, because I know a lot of you don't, so. Yeah, I'm just asking it in a nice way. So, yeah, well, anyways, besides that, I'm Joel Hancock, and I'll see you next time on Joel's Bellies. And my next goal, 250. Alright, that's it, everyone, for today. I'm Joel Hancock, and I'll see you next week on Joel's Bible Days. Bye.